Hi, my name is Miguel Aragon. I'm an assistant professor at UNAM in Mexico. I'm going to talk with you about a beautiful but kind of useless paper I wrote about cucumbers and the largest structures in the universe. We are going to do a very fast trip through the universe, and we just to have an idea of the scales involved. So we start on Earth. Earth is our planet. It's a planet that is part of the solar system, dominated by our star, the sun. But our sun is just one star among many. We see here the neighborhood of our sun. The scale here is 20 light years. We have like 50 stars. These stars are just part of a much larger system, the Milky Way. The Milky Way is this beautiful bright band that we see in the night sky. And the Milky Way contains something like 100 billion stars like our sun. But the Milky Way is only one galaxy among many galaxies, among billions of galaxies that we can observe. What we see here is the cosmic web. The cosmic web is this network that connects everything in the universe. So all these little blobs that you see here are galaxies, like our Milky Way with billions of stars. And you see how all these galaxies are connected through very, very thin bridges of matter. We call these filaments. Now, the cosmic web has several components. Galaxies aggregate into clusters, very dense, with tens of thousands of galaxies. And these clusters are joined by filaments. And together, clusters, filaments, and in three dimensions, walls, which are like membranes, they encompass these huge and vast regions we call voids that have nothing. Sometimes they have a few galaxies inside them. So just to remind you, in this map, every little dot that you see here is a galaxy like the Milky Way. And inside every galaxy, there are billions of stars like our sun. Now, the universe from far away looks a lot like a sponge. And we see here, I'm going to mark one little region. We see what I mentioned, clusters, which are like nodes on a network. We see filaments, which are like edges. In between the nodes and the edges, we form these cells, which we call voids that have no matter in them. I'm sorry. Now, on the left side, we have the universe. Like I said before, these little dots corresponds to galaxies like our Milky Way. Now, on the right side, we have a similar system that has the same structures, has also some nodes like clusters, has some edges like filaments, and has these empty cells. Now, I'm going to give you some clues. This is not the universe on the right. It's something else. I'm going to give just a few seconds to see if any of you can has an idea what this is. So on the right, we have the cosmic web. It's millions of light years in size on the right. But we have the foam inside a coffee cup. This is something that we saw a few years ago when we were having a coffee. Now, how is it possible that we see the same patterns in a coffee cup and in the largest objects in the universe? Now, we see these patterns everywhere in nature. This is another example. We have a cellular system here with nodes, edges, cells. Now, this corresponds to a phenomenon called crown shyness. Crown shyness is something that we don't really understand, but trees grow and they keep growing right until they touch each other. They just don't touch each other. It's like they give each other their space. It's something that happens among many kinds of trees all over the world. We also see this in the spots in the giraffe, the wings of the dragonfly. Now we take the universe and remember in this is a region that measures tens of millions of light years in size. And every little dot of light here is a galaxy. We can divide the universe into this cellular system. And then we can know that the universe looks a lot like soap bubbles. It also looks like shaving cream, like foam in a beer, like cucumber cells. Shyness, the crown shyness phenomena, the spots in the giraffe. So now there are 30 orders of magnitude between these processes. What is the common factor between them? What is the common theme? Well, the common thing is that these are Voronoi tessellations. And how do you make a Voronoi tessellation? You make a Voronoi tessellation by starting with some seeds, and then you let these seeds grow. And as they grow, when they touch, you start forming boundaries. And that's how you end up with this space partition. This is one of the things that once you see them, you just cannot unsee them. And this is what I wanted to let with you today. Thank you.